Guys, you know, when I bring messages to you on come on through the door, even when I'm on live or, you know, I'm just feeling what God wants me to say and I do a video, I pray to God that everyone have been taking heed to anything that the Lord has been using me to say. Come across harsh, come across. No, God wants you to love. You are my brother. You are my sister. I don't care what you have. You're no better than me. You're no better than him. You got a Mercedes Benz? All right, pay your car note. Love is what God wants from us. He wants us to love and give and help and encourage and hold and give a shoulder, lend your heart, lend an ear, lend a hand. God wants us to love one another. And I just got finished listening to JFK Jr. and I'm moved. I'm moved beyond. And I just pray that we don't mess it up. We getting another chance and I pray we don't mess it up. So take a listen. Jesus.
I want to give back. And, you know, that's what we're called to do, and to be as human beings, is not to just exist and work 9 to 5 in this crazy rat race, you know? And I just hope that the world, when it changes and we have this 1,000 years of peace, that we really can, you know, move into a much better place without this evil, corrupt.
Oh, the amount of light, the amount of energy that's going to be here on that day is just going to just, you know, it's infectious. It's.
Listen to the emotions that sweeps over every part of his body when he speaks of reintroducing his mother and his father and himself back to you, back to the world, back to this nation that they took away. Listen and hear and feel. If you don't feel anything from hearing this man, all he's saying is how he's thinking prior to doing it, introducing his parents, and he gets moved beyond being moved.
It's going to last, and it's going to be unreal. It's going to be like 9/11 on steroids, you know? Whitney Houston sang the best version ever, you know, of our national anthem. It's gonna be like that again, but so much better. It's just unreal.
I don't think there's gonna be a dry eye in the, you know, when they come back. You know what I mean? And
no, it's just, I had a tough time saying it the first time I said it. But, you know, I think, John's going to say these words. He's going to say, I'd like to introduce you to my mom. And my dad.
Jesus.
Just crazy.
It's going to be beautiful.
I don't know.
Jesus.
I feel Jesus. A world.
You feel a what?
Worldwide revival coming on.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Amen.
So much bigger than we can imagine.
Thank you for that, Michael. I've enjoyed speaking with you, and just that I've been sitting here just listening most of the time, and I just.
If the people that has been acting the fool continue to act the fool, I don't even know what else God can do for you. I don't. So it is my prayer that you get some sense, as my grandma used to always say, get some sense about you. That includes me too, okay? I'm not exempt. God has given us a second chance. He's a God of a second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. But how many times you get to say, We got a second chance at having a whole new world again. Please get yourself together. Work on your weight. Work on your attitude. Work on your mind. Work on your house. Work on being a better you. And if you could be a better you, that means you'll be better for you, your kids, and everybody else. I'm doing it. I do it every day, and I'm still not perfect. I'm still stubbing my toe. Jesus.